Welcome back, everybody, here to ESWC Qualifiers. Semi-final is what we are doing right now. Moscow 5 going up against No Tidehunter. It is the Western Qualifier we're doing. Let's jump ourselves inside the game. Game number one brought us picks, which we absolutely adored. And game number two, well, who knows what's in store for us? 1-4-3-7, man, we're about to find out.
For sure. I mean, last game, I feel like there was a huge misdraft coming out from No Tidehunter. And M5 just absolutely knew what they were going to do before the game even started. Mm-hmm. That, like, that's really all I can say. Like, they're like, they probably went into this game and they're like, okay, they're going to pick anti-mage. We know this. And then they just had something prepared already.
Yeah.
And that's and they just executed it perfectly. Well, it was pretty easy for them to execute this considering, you know, the other team is like, I don't know. It just felt like you're raping someone and they're not fighting back, you know?
Yeah.
Well, that's what it really felt like.
Well, you were saying yourself, like, how could they really fight back? They didn't have the power in the mid game. In this game, they've got to look to correct that. The Enchantress is going to switch hands, and Lashrak still well, going the way of Moscow 5. And Enigma will be the first pickup. Out of all the pickups, they want the Enigma and Moscow 5. I'm wondering if they're on purpose letting Black have that Naga Siren, or Admiral Bulldog gets his key hero. The lone druid's up for him, plus one now to come.
Well, this is the other problem. Last game, No Tidehunter had no idea of how they were going to defend this offlane, right? Maybe this game they will find something, but they picked Enigma, which means, again, they're going to have the same problem where M5 is just going to push in the short lane with Leshak and Enchantress and like two creeps and another a third hero, and they're not going to be able to stop this because Enigma needs a lot of levels, right? Or else she's not, or else he's not gonna be able to like, be efficient or whatever, because his power comes out of jungling and getting a lot of gold for your team and these core items.
Yeah, agreed.
And so is Lone Druid. He can't really defend towers as well. Maybe he can pull some creeps away, but if he's in the offlane, he's not gonna be a big threat.
Yeah, they need counter pushes like Venomancer or Shadow Shaman, guys that can shock down the creep waves.
Mhm. So, well, let's see what their third pick is here.
I'm Moscow 5 going to do early game pressure, but I just realized the Moronic isn't even thinking such a thing where there's an Enchantress and Lushrak in the pool already picked up for Moscow 5. Early game pressure? Nah, it's Moscow 5. They'll sit back. They'll farm. Aghanim, Scepter, and Desolator on the Enchantress.
Yeah. The thing about these CIS teams, they value Lushrak really high because with one spell Edict, he can take out a tower just by himself, you know? Whatever spell can take out a tower like that, like, it's amazing for these kind of teams that want these early game pressure and the early gold advantage to close these games.
Mm-hmm. Moscow 5 will now have Tidehunter as well as SK added to their list of bans to put against with Moscow 5 with the Broodmother coming up as their selection. So we're going to see split push. So what are we assuming? A 1-4 push coming up from Moscow 5? Broodmother off lane, just always pounding the crap out of that bottom lane.
Well, you could put the Broodmother off lane, but I don't think we should pass up the idea of this Broodmother being in the short lane
Chinese Dota, huh? Chinese Dota.
Well, it's not really Chinese Dota, but like, if you put this Broodmother in the short lane with the Ench and the Leshak and they can't defend anything, then you have like two creeps from Ench. You got Leshak with Edict and Broodmother with like massive broodlings, you know? Just going into your tier three tower at like 4 minutes or 5 minutes in the game. And how are you going to respond to kill those? Your Venomancer is going to be under leveled at like 5 minutes in the game. Enigma is going to still be jungling. And even if he does come out, he's only going to have like Black Hole. He doesn't have any AoE to take care of these creep waves.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, that's also something M5 could do. Put this Brood in the short lane and do that. The other option is put him in the off lane so he screws around with them so that they can't leave that short lane to go defend the long lane because M5 is pushing there, and then there's a Broodmother in their long lane, so it's like, you know, where do we go? Like, either way, somewhere is gonna get wrecked.
Yeah.
But, they should really ban this Sanking. Maybe Sanking. Sanking, Tide, I don't know. I feel like
actually, you know, there's probably no reason to ban out the Tide, and if they pick up SK, I'm talking about the Radiant side, if they pick it up, then they're in more trouble, because you'll have to play a farming SK, which actually isn't bad. SK should be the only one they ban, because Black, we know he loves to play that farming SK. And they can probably run the SK plus Venomancer in the middle lane, so running a melee here is not a bad option for
them. SK doesn't really do so well mid. He's better off in the short lane against his Broodmother.
But if you go with what you were saying before, that could be Broodmother on the easy lane.
Yeah. Then if they do that, SK still needs these levels anyways, right? To be able to compete.
Yeah.
So if he can get some solo experience in his SK can get some solo experience in his easy lane, he may be able to stop these pushes and stuff. But it looks like M5 doesn't even care about Tide or Sanking.
Yeah, they just let it go.
Yep.
I wonder if
Tinker, Invoker. Very nice bans, actually.
The only thing we got a little bit worried about, and this is something which we were talking about very earlier today, and that was Broodmother. With the change to her, and it's not a change to her abilities, but the cost of her abilities. So those spiderlings or the broodlings, they give out a lot of money. A lot more money than they used to. And when you got heroes now like Queen of Pain that are going to be looking to just scream down a very large portion of the spiderlings, it's going to be a large amount of money coming her way.
Mm-hmm. That's true as well. The other thing is the soaring as well. He's not going to be able to spam broodlings as much as he would like to.
That is true.
But I'm really interested. Okay, Tiny. Oh, it's going to be the black Tiny carry.
That's
they want to do.
It's still going to have to be Tiny and Venomancer in the middle lane.
No. It's going to be Tiny Venno in the easy lane with the Enigma in the woods, Queen of Pain mid, and the Lone Druid in the off lane.
Really? Admiral Bulldog has to do that? Man, I wish him all the best of luck. He is not going to have an easy time. Well, then again, so is Windrunner. Windrunner's not going to have a great time whenever she comes in close to Tiny. And Venomancer's harassment is just going to be a pain in the ass.
And there's one more option they can do, too. They can take the Enchantress tri-lane into the offensive lane and put the Broodmother in the short lane, where none of Tidehunter's heroes are going to be able to compete against his Broodmother 1v1. He's going to get absolute free farm.
Yeah. Unless they go Queen of Pain for the solo top, and even then it's difficult.
Even if they go Queen of Pain solo top, they're just going to get pushed by Ench, Leshrac, plus Windrunner, or even the last hero that they're about to pick.
With a quick rotation, that could work. But Moscow 5, they need like a stunning kind of carry, semi-carry here. CK would have been exactly what they want. Same with DK. Both would have worked perfectly.
CK, DK, NS, they banned them all.
Yeah. All they're looking for was the setup stun and a large chunk of damage. So Moscow 5 have to find that through somebody else now.
You know what else? You know, Alchemist got really buffed too. And you know what else is really good? Sven. The new Sven.
That's true,
Really, really good. His level 4 Warcry gives 16 armor in a 900 AoE when he uses it. 16 armor.
And that would work with it. That's a good AoE stun. It's good armor as well, and that's going to help you survive up against what you know is going to be a large amount of harassment, and they're going to go nakes instead. So it's going to be double slow to set up for the Leshrac stun, but that's still a large chunk of damage that can come out if they do it.
That's a 6-second duration on Rage.
And Windrunner for the solo mid with Stalina are going to take that one up.
The only thing is, they don't really have much shutdown for this Queen of Pain unless Broodmother gets like Orchids or something. So let's see how these lanes pan out, and then we'll know what M5 is going to do.
Instant smoke in base is what they're going to do. Everyone buy items and run out with smoke. A level 1 Rosh?
Nah, they can't do it level 1 Rosh with these heroes.
They've got a lot of consumables on the man. Like, everyone's got to salve at least 3 tangos.
Well, that's the thing. Tangos don't do anything in level 1 Rosh, and you need multiple salves.
So they're looking for first blood then.
They're looking for first blood.
And they're probably going to find it too, because we've got no Tidehunter moving out towards the bottom lane already. S4 on the Queen of Pain already leading at the front lines. So we've got Quicks on the Enigma. Admiral Bulldog, no surprise. Lone Druid, Black is onto that Tiny. And that caps off with Envy as our Venomancer. Already spotting each other out, though. The smoke was revealed, and Envy is rotating down a little bit too far. Selena could be looking for the best shackle of his life right now, and he could find it.
He could.
He's not leveling up, though.
Tiny's ready. Tiny's ready for this. He's like, bring it. Kill that bitch.
I got my avalanche, which isn't really what he wants to start with. He wants toss, really. But he'll have to deal with it. And Selena just walks away.
Oh, and Tiny actually has 1400 range, or 1300 range, from level 1 on toss.
That's because that got reworked, too.
Yeah, you know, oh, if he leveled Toss, he could have tossed the Venom onto him, and then he could have gilled him. That could have been so nice.
Then it could have been so first blood, throwing a Venomancer into all of Moscow 5.
Yeah, yeah. Throw him in and gill him. No, you do it when they're, like, running away, you know, because they're all spread out and things like that. You could probably catch someone easily with Venom, even if it's, like, a Windrunner.
As the ping's coming out from Enigma, just saying, hey guys, Solo's here, so they're not running aggressive tri-lane bot. In fact, it's going to be Enchantress finding some levels inside the Moscow 5 jungle, and then just Nexus and Dread. So a dual lane for the bottom. Seedoy will be on the safe lane on the top, and they completely abandon it.
Look at the creeps here.
What,
in
where?
The Dire jungle. He pulled them into there, and now they're getting denied. The bear pulled the creeps into the neutral camp.
That's not meant to happen.
Yeah, I think he was trying to block it, but it was too early when he was trying to leave.
It's a weird mistake from Admiral Bulldog to make when he's got that spirit bear.
M5's definitely laughing about this one.
Looks like Envy's not having the best time in the world in the bottom lane. Looks like Split Earth managed to hit him.
Ooh.
Also, to note too, that Nakes hasn't leveled up a single ability yet. He's not quite sure if he wants the Rage or if he wants the Lifesteal. Or if he's just waiting to level 2 before he's even going to reveal what he's got. Because they probably think he's got open wounds right now.
The thing is, he's trying to save his spell. Because let's say he gets Galed, he wants to skill his Rage so that he can dodge this Avalanche. But let's say this Venomancer gets out of position, he wants to skill his open wounds. And they get the kill on him with the Leshrac.
Yeah, so there's those two levels.
Level 2, he can get both of the spells.
Well, Enchantress being a bit of a dick to Envy, but Nexus, looking to dive. It's with a Haste rune, she wants to come in, and the Satyr, but they're going to go on black. They turn it around, Avalanche hit on Dread. Leshrac with a perfect, no! It's a two deep stun, but the first blood's still there. Envy just wants Dread, but I don't like his chances. And again, I don't like Nexus' chances either when he's taking up the tower, but Solo, he'll take it up. Nice Plague Ward, but Envy has locked himself in a corner. But that's the reason why the support is coming in. Black TP's in to help. Enigma rotates out from the jungle.
Even though they took so much damage from diving that tower, that first
Envy can't get out. Envy's locked in. He's stuck there for the moment. And he can't deny his own ward.
That's kind of funny how there's like this one ward, it's blocking this entire like
you just
zone.
Cut all faster.
All of that. Like how does that one, that puny little ward, you know?
Venomancer, it's his antennas that gets hooked on the ward as he goes faster.
He's hooked in the trees. He can't get out.
It's like, I just want to be free. I want to be free. I'm free. Nope.
Let's get the last hits and the knives out and see how everybody is doing right now. The bear, he was pulling the lane, right? But it was still a 1v1 lane. And that's exactly what they did. They did the offensive challenge with the Broodmother in the short lane so that he can win the lane against anyone that's there.
Mm-hmm.
But Admiral Bulldog is doing a really good job right now, at least, of getting the last hits. The farm in and whatever, considering he lost the whole entire creep wave.
Yeah.
Accidentally.
Even the middle lane's pretty balanced. Like, we've got Selena up against Queen of Pain. And that's 15 for 3 up against 13 for 5.
But I don't think this... I think Queen of Pain has the advantage in this matchup, but this...
Well, Solo, you're in a lot of trouble. Good. There's your toss you were looking for before. And now he doesn't need to gale him. Solo's completely blocked. Actually gets the gale out to 2. It hits on Dread, but look at the Enigma conversion. This freaking Ursa is trying to bring it, and then the conversion blocking it. Oh, it's beautiful play all round.
My goodness, the blocks by the Enigma. That was MVP level play right there. Block with one. Oh, okay, that's the neutral. So that's good. 3 seconds.
Wait, did he intend that? Yeah, he did. He's walked into the pit, and Dread just flames him.
That's really funny.
But it's faster than walking back to base. He loses less, I think.
The Enigma, the sentries, so that he can go to top lane and gank whenever he hits level 5 or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Or level 6. It's pretty easy kill with the bear and brute. Oh, look at this. This is what I'm talking about, where he can win the lane against any of them. He's just dumping all the spiderlings on Admiral Bulldog, and he just has to run back and regen. He only has one tangle left. Oh my goodness.
Look at him run.
More spiderlings.
Oh, also got to remember, too, he can't resummon the bear. And all it's going to take is one spider to be pounding on top of that bear. That's all it's going to take for him to be unable to reclaim the bear.
And these spiderlings, like, they
Can he get? He's trying to get a surround. I think he's trying to get a surround on this bear, or at least an Admiral Bulldog, because he's almost got level six.
He's gonna kill him.
There's the bear pulled in, nice entangle route.
Entangle. Oh no.
It could be either way though. These spiders want to come in. He's trying to use the bear to block, but there's a small avenue. Bulldog's gonna eat his way through further, but he can't do so. And then the bear comes in again. He gets an entangle on the spider. He's just living in the corner on 50, 60 HP.
That's ridiculous. That entangle came at the perfect time for Admiral Bulldog.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Living life on the edge, man. Living life on the edge.
Seriously. Wow. Why is Windrunner level 4 right now? This doesn't make sense. Radiant Queen of Pain's already level 6 now. He could kill her.
Shackle.
Yeah.
Blink. Ulti! Around the corner as Zalidus is like, sweet! Let's do this. I need one right click him with double damage and then a power shot, and I got this. And maybe he can. He's right there. He wants to line it up. He's just hoping that he comes in range. Not going to happen.
He's so hard.
There's your right clicks, man. Come on. Power shot as well, but it's so obvious when you're channeling it.
Uh-huh.
Oh, wait. Did he really get the counter kill on top lane?
Well, that's what happens when you root him.
and it's but a boom, boom, ching, and it's gonna be a top tier one talent deny as well.
All right, this is an Admiral Bulldog's bear. Okay, you don't question it.
Yeah, my bad. Sorry, I'm noob, as Dreads would say.
you just gotta let it kill people and you know, be in awe. Yeah, but the big thing in this game is Black. He is so shut down right now. He has 7 CS, but he's level 5 though.
He can't do anything down here. What's he supposed to do on this bottom lane anyway? He comes in close, he gets over. He's got a 3-2 combo. He is required to have help from Envy, who's level 2, who is food for Nexus.
Yep. That's what I said about this offensive Chai lane. Like, it's gonna be really hard for this Tiny, because they made it really obvious. This Tiny is going to be farming, you know?
Mm-hmm.
In the short lane, they're going to put this bear in the off lane.
Stelina. No, he's going to be okay. Never mind. No. Bottom lane's going to be more trouble. Nexus. He pops off the rage, try and get out of here, but he'll have to get in the side and just buy up his treads or something. Buy something. He bought double. Whoops! That's not intentional. And he can't sell that.
He can't sell it.
No.
Wait, you bought 3, I think.
Yes, it's Glance on the ground!
This is on the ground!
It's Envy! 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 What a... Envy! This direction! Right here! We can't draw anymore! They don't know it, though! They don't know it! How could he not know it? Is it nighttime? Yes, nighttime. The vision would have been enough. Sino's going to get entangled on the top lane, by the way. And this could be another kill for Bulldog. Is he going to get lucky for another entangle? Not going to happen. Nakes is back.
Nakes going to the
his gloves. You don't realize your own gloves are on the side. Gloves. We can't draw this ball. They can't see it. It's like screaming at a TV. Saying, man, look to your side. He dodges the gale and then it's going to rage himself away. When he goes in to buy his gloves, I reckon he'll go, oh, wait, are these mine?
Oh, man. But this is other Belt of Strength. Oh, he sold it. So sad for him. He sold it.
He could have probably saved and just gone for the Sanjay. Have it a little bit earlier on. Go on the side. He can't because he doesn't have the money to. If he had the money, he might think about it. But he doesn't have the money, so he's not thinking about it. And Dredd's in a horrible position. He's in no man's land here. Starts off with Edict, looks for the stun, can't claim it though. And he's coming too much damage from the Queen of Pain, who with one blink and scream could take this, but that's why Solo's coming in with a heal. As well as Dredd coming in without Dredd's towards the lane. And he's looking at Quicks just on the side. Just going to slow him. Remember, Quicks has that black hole, and there's a lot of conversions here. So Malivus stun, all the conversions will convert. And they'd already bring Nexus down to half life. Shackle will fly, but won't latch and everything. But the oh man, with the traps there,
tower.
Able to hold it. Windrun, just evasion, so we can get the last right click in. Next, get away from those damn conversions. He jumps in Infest and then jumps back out again. Still enough damage to kill off the conversion, but brings his life back up.
So, do you know what happened with Nexus's treads?
Yeah, he would have bought the items individually, and when you do that, if you buy an extra item when you buy it individually, then it just drops on the ground next to you.
Okay.
That's what's supposed to happen. It won't do it as well because he bought two of the frickin' Belts of Strength. And, okay, now he's gonna bring down Black. And he actually bought treads! Oh my god. Nice Quapaldi! Beautiful Quapaldi! And then your Black Hole to catch everybody else there! Gal gonna go through both them. Next on such low life. And Solo's gonna go down as well.
I do suffer fools.
Interesting.
Okay, who is gonna shop first and see it? It's S4. No! Nope, no!
The TP.
How long can it sit there? Everyone's buying stuff from every other shop by the secret shop. What's happening on the top lane too? Cedoy, he's trying to go on Bulldog. He's level 6. Never gonna happen. Selena comes back towards the bottom lane now. And looks like Quick's looking for a Malivus stun, but not gonna happen. Lashrak's not too far off as well.
Well, that power shot went the weird direction.
Yeah, that's... What the hell, man? TP's coming in, right on top of the tower. Shackle, what a shackle! Right on Quicks, then your Rage, then your Lashrak follow-up stun. And the heal from Solo keeping everyone up. He's right next to it! He's like, what the? Gloves! Gloves! No! Let ground! Ground! Look at you! It's like, Nexus, did you finally? What a type to him! Finally!
He found it.
Oh, I want to laugh my ass off. I want to... At least see if he wants to, he can buy Hand of Midas. Actually, no. It's his armlet. He can use it for the
armlet if he wants.
It still is going to work for him.
It's funny, Eternal Envy walked past it like twice. Yeah. Right on top of it. He stood right on top of the Gloves of Haze. And he didn't notice it.
There's a $500 item sitting on the ground for the last, what? We had an engagement in mid, took a tier 1 tower, we had two team fights on the bottom lane, and it still remained untouched for the man who initially bought it to come down here on the bottom lane and buy it again. And he's starting up his armlet. Oh, that's great. I love it. I love it. Oh.
Oh, man. It's okay. We got our fix of comedy.
Out. So there needs to be a Benny Hill video about that. There needs to be like a Benny Hill themed video about that because it's just
watch
so...
every time the Venom walks past it.
Yep, every time.
I
see nothing. I know nothing. I know nothing.
Oh my god! All right, they go for the Roshan here. This is a pretty good play actually. Unless they know that they're doing it, then this is gonna suck.
Conversions are coming in. The Venomancer Ward already spot the fact he just came out. But they're chaining it nicely, though. They're moving it between the center and the Alpha Wolf. They'll come out, kill a couple of conversions, go back in again. Now Envy, in fact, they're gonna find a kill on him. Open wounds and the power shot from Windrunner.
What you doing, buddy? What you doing?
Queen of Pain wants to jump in. She's got ulti, and it's a possibility that she can really screw with this a lot, but... Moscow 5 just have so much support around this Rosh pit that it's going to be a guaranteed Aghanim.
For sure. Venom's dead, and they have 4 heroes here. Tiny is under-farmed, and Celebrate can't do shit, so...
They've got to give this to somebody else, unless Nexus sells his stick. Okay.
Oh, Nexus is going to give it to Nexus, for sure.
Right. He's got the Agassi model.
Yep.
Did he sell his stick? What else did he sell? What else was on him, then?
I don't think anything else was on him. It was like a branch or something.
I'm going to double check because I know I clicked on him and this is the beauty of having a 30 second delay. I could check all this kind of stuff a little bit later.
Oh, okay. Oh! Admiral Bulldog got Midas. Jesus.
This is the way he likes to play. He sold Stout Shield. He sold his Stout Shield.
Oh, yeah, he had a Stout Shield. You're right, bro.
Yeah. This is actually something which a lot of CIS players have been doing with their lone druids. where they use the Hand of Midas and they keep it on the bear so he's getting the attack speed, and then we'll switch it back to the lone druid. And he'll just continuously just move it back and forth, because if you use it on the spirit bear, you don't get the experience boost.
But if you use it
on Admiral Bulldog, then you get the experience boost, but you want the attack speed on the spirit bear.
Right. That's pretty cool. Hmm. And he's going to get Radiant at a relatively good time. Probably around 19, 20 minutes, depending if they get any towers or not. He's going to have to hope for getting Radiance by 20 at least. Because we're going to see M5 going for some more tower pushes here, getting the tier 2 towers now.
Yeah.
What I'm worried about is who is getting a mech on their team. This Windrunner should have been the one getting mech.
But he'd be first four item stuff instead. Right now,
but he has 4 stuff.
It's almost like we're looking at carry Windrunner, which means the mech has to come for Latrak. Something's flying out right now.
Latrak can't do it. He's buying wards and things like that. And he's just tanking up. His job is just to tank up. Enchantress has three racers.
Solo probably could have bought it.
Yeah, for sure. This mech is actually really important because they have Tiny and Queen of Pain. Really bursty heroes. You want to heal that up so your heroes can stay and fight. So.
Well, it's the only other way around it is to have that. And also, where's the pipe of where's the pipe of inside?
Oh, pipe? I don't think they're going to make a pipe.
Oh, bear. Can't reclaim that.
You should have slowed it down, the Enchantress.
Mm-hmm. Oh. There's a 4 star getting away. Nice, Quapoli. Going to go through 3. Solo's heal's going to be enough. Looking for a couple of imps. And no, PGG! Screaming to go. Solo's on the run. Oh, man. It just seemed to be a dread hole as well. But Solo will go down in the end.
Wow, that courier is so fat right now. It almost died because it was running into all 5 of those heroes.
This is like, I'm trying to bring in drums. I got drums. Why is for the one hero that's dead?
Yeah.
Quicks, he is a long way from home, and there's an Orc in the Malevolence already up on Seedoy. That's also what the courier brought in.
Yeah.
And there's the resummon. He wants Quicks. Insatiable Hunger, holding off on the Orchid. And there goes the Orchid, shackle on the Bulldog. And man, that's the wrong. They can't make up their mind, but the Lashraxon will hold him there long enough. They're able to get the kill.
That was good. Nice shackle. Very useful shackle. I guess right now their thought behind not getting a mech is that they have Enchantress to heal them up for the moment. But this mech is still going to help if somebody can get onto it, you know? And they have Armlet now on the Nyx as well.
This is top tier 2 tower gone. They're eating through the backdoor regen. No glyph popping up to save this. There it goes.
Oh, there we go.
It was the double damage of Windrunner plus the edict damage. And Selenia just walks into the team.
Big shackle?
He almost could have if he wasn't stunned, but now S4, mini stun, it's long enough for Lothrak to follow through with his stun. Veno gets the Omen Black in through the rear, Avalanche Toss on both Solo as well as Selena, but because of the 4 star, he's now completely out of position. Quicks is also not in the best position of his life. Queen of Pain bought back, Tiny bought back, Tiny trying to TP into his middle lane, but Queen of Pain's already dead. Actually, it's Admiral Bulldog who's TP'd him, trying to find an opening with the bear. Dredd's going to TP himself out of safety. Black's not going to get there in time. Now open wounds, they're just eating through Quicks. That lifesteal and Alma manipulation, he's entangled for the moment, doesn't want to be. Avalanche and the toss on the Nexus. Not able to get the kill because he infests on the way down. There's your Armlet. Bumps it up, bumps it down. It's
Don't
so
forget,
hard to get the last hit. That is cool, that is true. And now he's down at 40. There he goes. And Armlet again. Evades the toss. Nexus on the run. There it goes. Stick charges as well, Avalanche, and Aegis will pop. He was thinking it could have been the best juke of ever, but he'll come back up to life again.
So hard.
And there's the toss. Black's running out of mana, and now he's been lifesteal. Lucky and Tangle going the way of the bear. And Dredd comes in to help.
But yeah. Now they only have 2 more tier 2 towers to go through. And Tidehunter lost a lot. They lost a lot during that engagement. This Tiny had to... He TP'd in, tried to go for a kill, stunned and tossed a different unit and stuff so he didn't get the combo off.
Mm-hmm.
And he had died, so then he had to buy back so he can try and save his team. But in the end, he really didn't get anything else either, except for the Nyx's Aegis.
Yeah.
And I think Yeah, the Aegis was actually running out too, because it's only 6 minutes.
That's
it only
true.
Lasts us for 6 minutes now.
It only had another minute from this time, or minute and a half, probably from the time he died, left on it. Kind of got to remember that change. This, yeah. For people who don't know about the changelog and haven't seen it, you can check out the changelog. Look up the news article, 6.75 is upon us over at joindata.com, and you'll find the changelog there. Or you can also listen to the Talk Data episodes from last week, where we talked about every single change in the log. It's about 3 hours and a half worth of changelog discussion, if that's the kind of thing you're in for. So,
oh
Lena,
my god, he missed Gale. Oh,
he missed Gale on a malificently not moving target.
Yeah, that kind of costed them that kill. Well, not really, because he has haste.
And he had four stuff.
Just kidding. it cost him the kill.
It wouldn't have mattered in the end.
Yeah. He forced... Yeah. Haste.
Yeah. Nice farm for S4. Just following with the spiders. Probably should be splitting up these spiders so we can't scream again like that. That's some easy money for Queen of Pain.
Yeah.
But yes, the change around Aegis Nimona before I forget what I was talking about. The Aegis Nimona only lasts for 6 minutes now.
Oh, there's a play happening.
Yep, it's on MV on the bottom lane. And two more imps now to get the kill. Yep, she has let off four. Did require a power shot too because stick charges were used. But at the same time, S4 is going to have some pressure to the tier 2 tower in the mid lane. Going to tank up a little bit as well because she's going to regen rune. She's fine. What? Sorry? I'm
talking about Aegis.
What? Yeah, I think I got the whole Aegis only last 6 minutes instead of a normal 10 out in the end.
Alright, so basically Tidehunter, what they're trying to do now is like, they know their only hope is Admiral Bulldog to try to get him to that Radiance. Because Tiny, he's basically out of the game right now, unless they start snowballing somehow, get some few kills on him, and he suddenly
Korea,
gets back.
Get away from S4! He's carrying a BKB up to the Broodmother on the top lane. S4 almost was able to kill it off.
Ooh.
That could have been a brutal thing for Cito not to have.
And this Brood is really, 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 really farmed right now. He's really, really, really farmed.
BKB, Orchid, and we're 21 and a half minutes in. That's because no one else is taking his jungle. Every single time he can, he moves the spiders into his own jungle, and Solo and Dread have just set up camp in the Radiant jungle. So
exactly.
Moscow 5 are doing exactly what we saw from Orange earlier today, where they just control every portion of farm anywhere on the map.
The Nyx farms like whatever he possibly can. Ancients, mid lane, bottom lane, whatever. Windrunner, Leshrac, and Ench, they just farm together whatever they can. Lanes, jungle, opponent's jungle, and everything. Let's look at what the gold graph is.
It's not cool, man. I was bringing it up before.
8k gold advantage for F5 right now. And experience is okay, 4k. But, I mean, gold really does tell more in this scenario.
Well, S4 should not be taking these last hits right now. Should really not be taking these last hits. Actually, it's enough. It's just enough. Bulldog now for is Radiance. And there's 1800 on S4 as well, so his BKB is getting closer, but not really close enough.
I don't think they can kill this guy top.
I think all they want is the spiders. If they can kill him, great, but if they can get the spiders, it's going to be even better. There's your sentry ward, and BKB's going to pop.
That's fine.
Yeah.
I don't think he cares much about that.
Well, BKB's down, so maybe they're thinking about the tier 1 tower. Ping's already coming, it's like, please CP to the tier 2.
What does Enigma have? Okay, he has a mech, he doesn't have a BKB. If he had a BKB, then he could get like a full 5-second black hole on. Yeah. And still, they don't have
that. Here's how TP's coming in. Look where Quix is, he's having a TP out, he's too far up. Windrunner 4 staffs in, there goes the Venomancer, he'll TP out as well. Bulldog, he's the critical hero. He's already bought the Radiance though. And they weren't attacking the Bears, so the Bears able to be recalled. I don't know if that was probably the wrong target they're going for, considering, well, even then. Put the bear on cooldown is one thing, but...
And actually, Tidehunter bought a lot of time there. Like, they tried to go for the Broodmother, he used BKB, they tried to go for the tower, M5 tried to react by defending it, and they lost nobody. So basically, since they were already behind, they gained just by making those plays. So now they're less behind, let's say. And look at Tiny. He's actually been at this bottom lane for like the past 3 minutes since the last time I mentioned him. And he managed to farm up a Yasha now.
slowly niggling his way closer and closer.
Yeah, he's slowly getting back there. Just freezing that lane, so that's one less lane for M5 to try and farm.
Mm-hmm.
And this is where it gets really tricky. Like, M5 still haven't pushed that tier 2 mid, and getting into that base is not an easy task to do with heroes like Brood and Snakes and stuff. Because Titans actually have some decent teamfight, and they have Radiance too, so if someone gets some bad root or get picked off, that's a lot of time that they will buy for them to catch up.
That's true. But again, it requires someone to be picked off. I don't know if you also noticed too, if anybody from Titan is picked off, then Nex is going to completely disintegrate them.
We've got
Windrunner with an Invis rune trying to set up for the best Shackle of a life, so this Desolator on Nex can just eat through them all. And Envy, he's a long way out there. There goes a mini Shackle and Power Shot, but that's not who they want to fight on. In fact, Black tossing Solo back into the team, and now there's the gem.
There's a gem on the ground too. Oh no, that ain't good for them.
And then the chase. Stellina's on out, so there's your pick-off you were looking for.
Yep.
And what Tunnel needed.
And for what Tidehunter to come back, and that's exactly what needed to happen. One person on M5, any one person on M5 just dies, then they can get a lot more control of the map.
But then again, look at Sidoi in the top lane still. He continues to put out. He got 220 CS.
Yeah, he's pretty fat.
And
he's
now buys an Eagle Song. So we'll see Butterfly coming out from him not too far off. But so big.
He is really big. But the only problem is Enigma Black Hole, Cillabear Root, especially since he doesn't have Manta, and Tiny late game carry are all better than this Broodmother, basically. Mm-hmm. As fat as he possibly can get.
It's true.
All those combos can, you know, break this Broodmother. It's not like a anti-mage or something where he just splits and then just rapes everyone and you have like no shot when he has like four items or something.
It's true, it is the downside of Broodmother.
You can still stop him, yep.
I think the biggest problem right now for Moscow 5 is the fact they just cannot stop Black from farming on the bottom lane. They're trying to force him out and force him to TP in towards this middle tier 2 to try and defend it. But while he keeps farming up, he's getting closer and closer towards that Aghanim Scepter. And once we hit that point, then we're in dangerous territory for Moscow 5. Because it won't just be the fact you lose a battle. You'll lose tier 2s, tier 3s, that nice damage onto that bear.
Oh my lord, that Desolator is just doing so much work. And the 6 second Nyx rage, it's so significant.
Mm-hmm. Can't be touched, because that was another buff that happened to Nyx.
Uh-huh.
Trying to just move back a little bit further. Not liking this middle lane engagement at all. And at the end of the day, Notanunda says we're going to lose this tower anyway, may as well just deny it, it's in range.
Mm-hmm.
So get rid of it all. And then we can push into the tier 3 tower, but this is really early for Moscow 5 to go in, especially when all oldies are up for Notanunda. Even with an Aegis of the Immortal, it's dangerous for them to push in. It's got to come with a split push. Brood through the top and the rest of the team through the bottom, it's the only way this is going to work. But when they push out the bottom, again, Black, I haven't seen the creep wave move past here. It's sit there and it hasn't come past this point. Black is farming just in this box.
He's in his own court right now.
Yep.
He's in his own court.
It never goes past this point.
And you know what's funny? He's slowly getting to that Aghanims.
Yeah.
He hasn't even killed anything or fought anything in the past, like...
It's got 3k
minutes?
Gold.
I don't know what it is, how long he's been down here. 10 minutes?
He's almost got more CS than Lone Druid. just from the... And we all know his start. We know what kind of start he had.
Yeah.
And again, this is just great lane control, but this is what Black is also very well known for. If there's farm anywhere on the map that he is capable of getting, he will do it. He will find it. You give him 5-10 minutes... And he'll come out with a tier 3 item.
Or he'll come out with like 2 tier 3 items.
Mm-hmm. this is the problem for Moscow 5, but then again, well, his timing is going to be right. By the time he has Aghanims, he can even afford a Blink Dagger if they leave him down here for too bloody long.
Mm-hmm. He's not going to get Blink. He's going to get Aghanims.
He's actually 800 gold away from his Aghanim Scepter. This is stupid!
Okay. So basically, yeah, this is what M5 has said. They have to smoke gank here. Like, no Tidehunter, they don't have to do anything. They can just sit back and keep farming as long as you don't die. Because they're gaining
They're ganking bot. They're going to kill off Black. It's what they need to do. And they need the secondary slow. They need that enchant slow. Wonderful avalanche. And then tossing Nexus a little bit further back. And maybe there is enough damage to kill off Black. He can buy two of his items. But the stun already starting off. Malivus on solo. Remember, Black Hole is there. And there's two heroes he might be able to possibly grab right now. In fact, there's going to be two, three heroes instantly canceled from that shackle. Perfect shackle out from Selena. He's going to hit on and bring down the Enigma. Now he can focus over towards Black. Just one to the next to the next. He needs one last right click. Not going to claim it. Tries it on Bulldog. Both on low life. Seedor even part of this fight. Spiders, cooldown for 5 seconds. Now they're going to go on the bear. Has that even got cooldown? If they kill off this bear, it might be enough to kill off Lone Druid. No, Bulldog, he's already using Tranquil Boots. Getting back into the base.
Enigma bought back. Did they pick up the gem? I think they picked up the gem.
I don't see the gem on anybody unless they denied it. Broodmother just bought his entire butterfly. And the bear comes back and look at Nate just open up on it. Right click it with Arm and Deso, Seedoy, Avalanche, he's gonna go down. They still wanna kill off this bear and Nexus. He can trade his Aegis the Immortal for the bear, not worth it. Because Bulldog can just resummon and go all over again. And now Nexus pops off the rage. He's trying to go for the bear again. And he's infested. He's in the melee creep. He's in the melee creep at the back.
Enigma? Kill it?
Conversion! He doesn't know! Maybe he doesn't know which one. He's like, ah, it's fine.
Shrinking him.
There we go, he's out! And he can run! Avalanche gonna miss because he hits the, oh, he starts off on Black! Black! The Lautrec's done! Eating damage! Might be enough! And Nexus keeps on trying to fight this one off! They do bring down Black! Big kill for him, and the Imp's coming out from solo. That'll pick off one support hero, but now there's three on his tail. Shackle from Selena, only thing that might save him. Shackle won't latch onto the bear, and solo, look at that speed. I didn't realize he's gonna haste through him, but S4, body blocking him, looking at him just twitching the wings around. And they can't get away, and Selena on the run out. Enchantress instantly biased back into the game as well.
All right, so... that was quite the interesting fight. Like, this Broodmother, I don't know, he kind of suicided. He didn't have BKB and he got Enigma stun. And he still tried to go inside their base and try to do something. And he just instantly died there. Like, when you're playing like this hard carry Broodmother where you have all these items, you can't be dying like that. When you die, you just give away a lot for your opponent. Because you're not farming. During that time, you're dead. And you need to keep on snowballing. Yeah, you're this far ahead. And no Tidehunter, lost no Raxus still.
That right? T3 tower on bottom lane is pretty damaged though. So if that happens again...
they didn't lose any Rax. Mm-hmm. And the longer this game goes, the stronger they're going to become and the more even the game will become too.
True.
So it's getting a little bit scary for M5. Let's say in the beginning they had this game in the bag. But now like slowly they're losing that.
Oh, Black. So gonna die if that stun didn't keep on latching on Seedoy. He didn't pop the BKB for the kill.
Like, it's impossible for him to actually kill this tiny. It's got Craggy.
Oh man. As Stalina is now hunting on the top lane too, he's managed to find himself an Invis rune. So hoping that there's some space for him to play. Oh, I just realized too, Roshan. Gotta remember the timer on him. 1 minute and 45 seconds left before Roshan will respawn. So prep time will now be for both these teams to ensure they get that Aegis.
Yeah. What's he going? Is he going crit or MKB?
Oh, trouble. Bulldog just realized he's shackled to his own bear on the top lane, being focus fired down by Selena, who holds
damage
with the Hex and the Orchid. They just went through Lone Druid's life points at Ultimate 4 with a Broodmother and Windrunner.
But that's because he has like no, I don't know, even in his ulti, he's pretty weak right now against this butterfly Broodmother. Just does so much damage. Oh, they were waiting on the Roshan and they realized the timing was a little bit wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Still another minute left.
And now smoke gank time. They're trying to use Black as bait on this top lane. They must be looking for the Broodmother. First person to the front line is a Venomancer who's got Sentry Ward. So they're just looking to get him out of position when he comes down the web and then just gale him out.
The thing is, like, this team should know this, that Roshan is about to spawn.
Sidoy! He walks back into it. The web will go on the BKB as well. Sentry Ward or not. I'm surprised he didn't just TP out. Is it going to be too late? It's going to be too late. Avalanche too early.
Okay. That's a 7. That's an 8. That was an 8-second BKB.
That had to be bloody close, man.
Yeah, it really was. what's interesting is, like, normally all the teams would know, like, when Roshan is spawning, right?
Mm-hmm.
So they should know that this Roshan was spawning within, like, 5 seconds before that smoke gang.
So they go hunting top instead of coming for Roshan.
They went hunting top instead of going for Roshan, which was interesting because normally there shouldn't be any heroes top. But this Broodmother was. So it's kind of weird.
That's an Aegis Immortal, and
she's trying to get a fight before Roshan happens so you can steal it. But yeah.
Someone's going to take the cheese. It's going to be Stalina's. He'll come in and probably... Oh, what's he going to sell? TP? Yeah, he drops the TP and picks up the cheese. So we've got cheese on Stalina, and we're going to Monkey King Bar on Nexus with an Aegis Immortal, Desolator, and Armlet 35 minutes in. He's looking really sweet. Sure.
But he got Monkey King Bar. Or he could have got... He actually should have got Abyssal Blade instead.
That's true.
It would do so much more for him. Or even AC would have done a lot too. But he got MKB. I don't know. Maybe he knows something I don't.
He is Nexus, man. He played Drone Range before and it worked, so he knew something the Pumpy and both Sin didn't know. Just saying.
No. I knew this draw was going to rip. You know, we have faith, right, Toby?
Yeah. That's right. Together we stand. United Drow fans. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Bottom lane push is going to happen. Black should be able to hold most of this. The question is going to be where the pressure is going to come from another lane. These spies are not being marked on the top lane. I'm seeing Cedar just leaving these guys up here.
Is the stun. Now they're free to go in.
Oh, hey, man. Look at Quabs live. Both Orchid. Actually, it wasn't even the Orchid. That was just right-clicking.
Yep. This Windrunner, he forced the Queen in and hexed him immediately. That was absolutely brilliant play right there to get that Queen of Pain. Now they're just going to wait out for the Hex to be up again so they can fight properly.
Mm-hmm.
Well. And he has a Basher. Okay. Sidoy has a Basher now. So he's going to be able to hold down someone pretty easy. Oh, Enigma, BKB, big item.
Maybe he's going to be his moment.
It's going
to have to be his moment.
Yep, he cannot be cancelled anymore. That's huge. Oh,
well,
he's just gonna
look at the racks! There goes a Shackle, doesn't latch, and this can be the moment BKB, but everyone just forced and retreats! And this BKB will go on cooldown! Oh, we are in trouble! BKB's on cooldown for him, Queen of Pain still has hers.
Now they still have like three heroes who can
Shackle! On Quab! Oh man! 4 hits from a raged up Nexus! It's more than enough! Now Cedo is in a little bit of trouble. Avalanche toss, even with the BKB, but look at that insatiable hunger. He wants his life back. Then the Black Hole, both Dread and Cedo, both caught out. Remember, Aegis Immortal is still up on Nexus, who stands his ground. He will not go critical. He will. Venomancer is right clicking with Poison Sting, so that's the reason why he went down. But they can go back in and finish this Rax. There's a right click, fortification. It's on 4 HP. Envy in too close. 4 clicks to bring him down. Then finishes the Rax. Black still not 100% sure about it. It's in 4 stopped away. Nexus getting avalanched. He still wants to bring down. Is he thinking about the bear? That bear doesn't have a reason. If they can kill this off right now, that is a huge kill for them. Solo too low on life, gonna burn out. The creep wave also going to bring him down. Stalina needs out. 4 stop on cooldown for 1 more second. It's not enough time. And Nexus wanting to bring down Black. He doesn't have infest. He needs to live. He needs to live. There's a right click.
Oh, Black turned around. He was slowed. He was not going to kill Black at all. And Admiral Bulldog was going to get him for sure.
Uh-huh.
A slight misplay by Black. But M5 got really, really, really over-aggressive there. They got the melee racks and they could just get out and regroup and go for another push again. But instead they got greedy and they lost 2 more heroes for no reason.
But they still take the racks.
Oh, actually, Admiral Bulldog is close to another item. He has a Radiance AC. He's going to get 1 more. I wonder what he's going to get, actually.
Where's his cash coming from?
It's a mix of the Midas, the Radiance, you know, killing creeps, and maybe some spiderlings as well.
He's got the highest net worth in the game, man. Higher than Broodmother, Nakes,
like,
and...
He got it so early, right?
Yeah, it was pretty early.
Yep.
It's like 30 minutes use of Midas is a lot.
Actually, why did Seedoid just jump up all of a sudden? Or what did Lone Druid just buy? Lone Druid just spent a large portion of money. He's buying Monkey King Bar.
Is he now?
Yeah, it's going to be for his bear, obviously. And the courier just goes completely the wrong direction.
what's he doing down there? He's going to the Windrunner. Windrunner, complete.
It's where Lone Druid was.
Okay.
So he'll come up here, get the Demon Edge, finish the full Monkey King Bar, and then fly back down and put it on his bear.
MKB. I guess that's a good item because of Spider. He causes things to miss if you attack them, so...
In the buy, not to mention Windrunner too. Windrunner just won't have that room to play around with.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wondering what next item will be as well. If we see him go more damage, go that crit, because he hasn't been dying in the fight. He's going to go Basher. He just bought a Basher.
Yeah, for sure. He needs the Basher so that he can hold down these heroes. They don't run away from him. That's what I was thinking. I don't think this MKB was a good purchase for Nyx.
Windrunner just bought a straight BKB.
That's pretty good. It's a lot of this Venomancer ultimate and Queen of Pain.
Oh,
is
S4.
So much.
It's going to be big trouble for him if they can get that open wounds. There's the slow. Oh, nice! Orchid!
Forced the BKB. They forced the BKB. That's big.
Mm-hmm. 70 seconds. Looks like there's a little bit more trouble for Selena.
He's going to cut. Okay.
He's going to force stuff out. And the courier. Well, that wasn't a courier. I thought I saw balloons drop for a moment. I'm like, oh, there we go. But nice entangle. There's that quick damage that comes out from that Monkey King bar. Not to mention the already stacked up. Look at the Pulse Neonic. Nice Black Hole holding Nexus. He's a big one. Black even rotates down so he can get it and also get the mech charge. And then they can move on to Dread. He'll get himself a decent stun, but not enough to get a kill. And Black just clubs him with a tree.
Wow. Well, that's another minute and a half at least. No Tidehunter just bought themselves to push out lanes, get a little bit more farm, maybe get another item going. And that's exactly what they're doing right now.
What did Black just finish? He finished up his Mana Style.
Oh boy, that's actually a really big item for Tiny. Finishing up this Manta with Aghanim's up. It's going to be really hard to kill this Tiny now. Because he got to go through his illusions as well.
It's just getting more brutal and brutal as time goes on.
Yeah, what Enchantress we even... has to steal one of these illusions or something and deal with it like that.
It's still 10k worth of gold going Moscow 5's way, and and now the experience updates to only be about 3k worth. The really funny thing is that even though there are tier 2 towers and tier 3 towers up, their Rax is just as exposed as Moscow 5. Because if either Tiny or Lone Druid survive, they're in trouble. If Tiny and Lone Druid both survive, it's Rax.
Yeah, for sure. The thing is, if no Tidehunter actually wins a team fight, like where Nyx and Broodmother dies, I think they're going to come into the lead, even if they are down one Rax. Because that's just the nature of the heroes no Tidehunter has. Mm-hmm. Cillibear and Tiny, they are insane pushers. They're going to take down towers in seconds.
I don't know if you also see it too, but Enigma just bought his Blink Dagger.
Oh, yeah.
So he's Blink, BKB, mech.
I've been waiting for this.
S4
is actually really, really, really poor. He's not having a good game at all this game.
Wait, Nexus just spent his cash as well. Or did he? No, it's just... He's broke. Nexus is completely
broke. Well, he bought the Basher and he didn't get it to him in time. Yeah. Maybe Sadoi might finish his Abyssal Blade because they need that to kill this Enigma.
Mm-hmm.
This Abyssal Blade. Because unless he screws up and uses BKB again before Black Hole, they're not going to be able to really take him out.
We've got a Basher on the bear now, too. So we've got Stun, we've got Entangle, we've got Aura. First for the armor, and then for the burn, and then the true hit with the Monkey King bar. The only thing in which he's got to switch off soon would be his Hand of Midas. And that's to put a Mjolnir up on his bear. And then it's the most tankiest bear in the world. The problem he's going to have is if he loses the bear.
Actually, I think he should get a Ghost Scepter on his hero. Because they're just going to try and focus on his hero. Yeah. And he has nothing to stop them from doing that.
Yeah, well, at this point, they can't kill the bear. Well, they can, well, but if only they have enough opening.
You want to Ghost Scepter your hero. Because the snakes can just go on this Scyllabear, the hero, mm-hmm. and he'll kill him for sure. If they get some kind of stun on him. And then what's all this use of your bear having all these items, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You should get a Ghost up there.
Perfect timing from No Tide Hunter. The line's already been drawn to walk up and through. So go up the middle lane and then come down. And they might be able to get this kill on Selena. Remember, he does have that 4-star from BKB, which is not going to be easy. And Roshan is up in 5 seconds' time.
Yeah.
And Black is already showing himself here in the middle lane. It's almost trying to bait Moscow 5 to kill him. But the support's coming down. And Lashrak, if he walks up close enough, you realize the smoke is there. But by doing so, 4-star, he has got to get out of here right now. BKB looking for the stun, but getting entangled instantly. Now's your black hole. 3 caught out. Nothing but Seedoy. And that's going to be Selena. Also with his BKB popping Midnight Pulse. Wonderful Shackle. They're going to bring down Bulldog. This is going to be a big kill. The aura's going to go, but it's not enough damage. He's forced to retreat back out again. Massive fight for Tidehunter. Or I say no, Tidehunter.
That's what I mean. If this is
Seedoy ball back. Seedoy ball back. Are you going to try and contest this?
There's no chance.
There's Sentry Wars here. He's going to come in. Selena looking for a shackle. Even if they can swipe off Roshan, there's a shackle up on the bear. Roshan at 800. 800. Maybe enough. Lone Druid goes down. Avalanche toss, not enough. New Insatiable Hunger still here. Blink away. He had to go out. Seedoy goes Scepter. It's too much. And Roshan will be killed by Tiny. And the cheese is on the ground, which will be taken by Queen of Pain. Man, that was one hell of a fight to try and go for that. But the Ghost Scepter from Venomancer couldn't have been at a better time. Because Queen of Pain needed that lifesteal to live. And at the same time, we should also point out, bottom racked is gone.
That's fine. Honestly, no Tidehunter is in the lead at this point in the game. Like, even if, what's the gold graph say? Even if the gold graph says they're down like 5k gold, that's actually 46 minutes in the game, 5k gold is like nothing. That's like what, 1k gold advantage on each hero or mm-hmm. something?
Yeah, not much.
Like, it's nothing at all. And even if this Rax is down at bottom, M5 can't actually take another Rax. Because they can't seem to win another fight.
Nope.
They've lost the last 3 fights in a row.
Well, this is what we're talking about earlier today with the cap abilities of heroes like Enchantress. She can't push in. She doesn't have Aghanim Scepter. Doesn't even have a hood for her team. She is walking around doing almost nothing but I will buy smokes, I will buy wards, and throw out whatever imps I possibly can. Yep. And then you've got to add to the fray too that you got Broodmother as well as Nakes, your two big damage dealers who can't just sit at the edge. They've got to get in close. And getting in close is very, very difficult when you're going up against Enigma Black Hole. A lot of stuns coming your way. The Entangle's looking for it as well. It's going to be difficult. And yeah, Stalina, he's currently infested. He'll force staff himself in. More BKB. They're going to find Envy completely out of position. Shaka will fly, will not lash, but out comes Nakes. And there's that Ghost Scepter again. Going to buy response time. And Nima wants to come in, but the Black Hole's on cooldown for another minute. There's Edict. He's going to live through this. And they're getting back getting a return kill. There goes Enchantress. Selenia will still go down. Black is unable to be killed here by Nexus. And then the return kill. Avalanche kill. 3 heroes on the sideline. Wonderful blink as well. Gain the return kill on Lashrak. And Seedoy tried to give whatever momentum he could towards that middle lane. But Moscow 5. Again being duped by the Venomancer of all heroes. Who lived through the engagement.
Got his ulti off before he died as well. And,
he never died. He got the Ghost Scepter and got back to base safely. He never died.
Oh, he didn't die after.
Moscow 5.
They
didn't lose a single person during that. Aegis wasn't lost.
I mean, M5's mindset was in the right place, like to try and go and make something happen, you know, try to get a pick off because they knew that they're not going to win another team fight ever again unless they get some kind of pick off and they get some amazing fight going.
Look at Black. He's on defense, dude. The only man that can defend up against the Broodmother, while Admiral Bulldog just solo killing off towers. And wants to get there. He will get this. They can't stop it. The Rax goes down and the fortification was on cooldown. Maybe they can kill off this bear. And it can't be re-summoned for 25 seconds, but whoop-de-doo, the bear's too fast. He can't catch it. It's too... Yeah. It's away. It's away. It's away.
And you know, earlier we were... When M5 was really far ahead, we were talking about Broodmother and how he was getting fat and the nature of the hero. And that's exactly what's happening right now. There's Enigma black holes and bear roots and Tiny. Fat Tiny with... Oh, he has a butterfly now on Tiny. Oh my god, now he's gonna miss too if he tries to attack this. Not only Craggy, but misses on the Tiny.
This I think has got to be a blend of things. It's got to be a blend of what Queen of Pain, Enigma, and Venomancer represented in the mid-game. Moscow 5, they knew they had to push in, and they needed to get more than just the bottom racks. It's almost why they kind of suicidally pushed that bottom rack to start with. They know they had to try and force it. Mm-hmm. And when they forced it, they realized it just kept on dying, and that was giving the levels and the advantage a little bit the way of no Tidehunter. Mm-hmm. And then you get heroes like Tiny, who can then buy space, because Moscow 5 realized that after two attempts, actually I think it was three attempts it took them to try and take out that bottom racks, it was just too much they were giving away. So they needed some more critical items, and in that time, all the farm time was there for Queen of Pain to get her items, Blink Dagger BKB up on Enigma, Black who managed to farm his Aghanim Scepter, and now going to get Avalanche, four stuff away with Stellina at the right time too, because Black was wanting to toss him back into the midst of his team, and that would have been GG. If you lose one hero right now, this is over.
Yeah, they're going to lose this Rax here, mate. I don't see them defending this at all.
Well, we're about to find out. It's going to be pushed to the test. Black Solo and Nexus.
Yes, Aegis. He's just gonna
there goes the shackle. Goes on the bear as well as Black. Maybe it's going to be an opening. They're trying to kill up the bear. Well, S4, there's your blink in with the black hole. They do bring down the Broodmother. Solo doing whatever damage he can to that Queen of Pain. Now pops his own BKB off. Nexus beats down the Queen of Pain. So they defend one. Maybe they can defend two. Stellina with his BKB tries to vibe up against the Venomancer. Broodmother will still take a fall. Enigma's going to buy back into this game. It's just too much. Black is too big. And GG calls out from Dread. We are going to a third.
Yep. The biggest problem this game was when M5 was in the lead and they were farming all the lanes, they let Black sit at bottom and freeze that lane for over 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. And Bear was free farming the top lane as well. So what M5 should have done was smoke up and go to that Tiny, stop him from farming it, gank him, kill him, do something, and just take the racks. But they spent too much time trying to do other things, trying to get this tier 2 tower mid instead of trying to, you know, like handle this Tiny and stop him from farming for 10 minutes, freezing a lane.
Let's see if they made the mistake again. Game number 3 coming up for you in a moment. Moscow 5 going up against No Tidehunter for their deciding match to see who gets to go through into our grand final best of 5 to be played tomorrow for the ESWC Western Qualifiers. We'll be back.